Welcome. This is Accounting with Bennett Tchaikovsky. Our topic today is property, plant, and equipment, and this copyright tribute goes out to Brooke. Copyright 2008 to 2018 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights reserved. Okay, so for another tribute here, we have a company, Sahar's Mom Class Call, Inc. Purchased equipment on April 1st, 2018 for $400,000. The equipment cost $80,000 to install, and the shipping shipping the equipment to SMCCI's facilities was $20,000. The equipment is expected to last for 5 years and has a salvage value of $200,000 and is expected to produce 20,000 units in the equipment's lifetime. 1,000 units were produced in 2018 and 5,000 units were produced in 2019. The first thing we're being asked to do is to determine depreciation using straight line for the year ended December 31st, 2018, and then to record the journal entry. What I also want to do is kind of look at, though, how we depreciate this asset over its entire life. So, well, let's go ahead and do the first part first. The first thing is, well, we've got to have acquisition cost minus salvage value divided by the estimated useful life is giving us our full year of depreciation. So what goes into acquisition cost? Remember, the acquisition cost is that cost where it's basically, what do I need to pay to get this asset ready for use? It will include installation, it will include shipping, any kind of initial calibration or initial testing, anything related to get that asset up and running. If it is routine maintenance or some other type of, let's call it just ongoing maintenance, that is not going to be a part of acquisition cost. So for our acquisition cost, I have my purchase price. I then have my installation. I then have my shipping. So my purchase price was $400,000. My installation costs were $80,000. And then my shipping costs were $20,000. And we're paying for all of these costs, and therefore it's going to be part of our acquisition cost. So my acquisition cost is going to be $500,000. The salvage value, or the $200,000, or what I expect to sell for that asset for at the end of its useful life must be deducted in this method. It is incredibly important for us to remember that we cannot depreciate an asset beyond the salvage value. We have to stop. We have to stop depreciating once the net book value gets to that salvage value, and we'll take a look at that down below in a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and divide this by my estimated useful life, which is 5 years. And so what I'm going to get here is $300,000 divided by five. Or here for a total of $60,000. And this is going to be for full year depreciation. So $60,000 is for one full year of depreciation. Depreciation. Thank you, Yvonne. And so I'm going to have right over here $60,000 for full year depreciation. And what I'm then going to do is I'm going to say, all right, I've got the $60,000, so this is a full year. But if I'm being asked to determine the depreciation using straight line for the year ended December 31st, 2018, how many months did I use this for? Well, when I look up here, I bought the equipment on April 1st, 2018. Can I say that this problem was a joke, Tchaikovsky, and it never happened? You're fooling me. No, I can't. So right here, I'm going to basically take $60,000 times 9/12. Well, why 9/12? So April 1st through December 31st is 9 months. And this will give me a total of 45,000. So right here, the amount of my depreciation expense for the year ended December 31st, 2018, it's going to be $45,000. So my journal entry is going to be a debit to depreciation expense. I'm going to credit accumulated depreciation right here for 45,000. And I'm almost done. What am I missing? With my journal entries, remember, I have to indent. Very, very important. So when I'm calling this, I'm gonna say to record depreciation expense, and I'm done. So that's what we needed to do. We can determine the amount of the depreciation, and we just did a journal entry to record it for the year ended December 31st, 2018. Now, by way of illustration, if we went through and depreciated this asset for 5 years, or for a total of 5 years, what would this look like in terms of a balance sheet presentation? So my equipment has an initial balance of 500,000. That was my acquisition cost. And right here for 2018, the amount of depreciation that I recorded was $45,000. And this was really covering me from April 1st through December 31st, 2018. Now, in terms of my balance sheet presentation for the first year, it would basically be 500,000 minus the amount of the accumulated depreciation, or here for a total of equipment net, 455,000. Now note, after this first year, I'm fine, because when it comes to salvage value, I'm still above salvage value. Remember, my equipment net can never go below salvage value. So I come here to 2019, and how much do I record? Well, 2019, 2020, 2021, 2022, I was basically using this for a full year. So when I go through and do this, this is gonna be 60,000. 60,000, 60,000. And when I get to 2023, it's a little bit strange. Why is it a little bit strange? Because I really, if I hit March 31st, or really like that partial year, I will have fully depreciated the asset. So in that last year, I can only take 15,000, or basically 60,000 times 3/12, or from January 1st through March 31st, 2023. Remember, the asset had a 5-year estimated useful life. I can only depreciate the asset for 5 years. And again, the reason is, when I look at here as of the end of 2023, my equipment net value balance here is 200,000. I have to stop at this amount, and why? I cannot depreciate beyond my salvage value. If I do, what's going to end up happening is I can't do it, because this is what I'm expecting to recover. Okay, so that is straight line. We will take a break, and we'll come back for you in a bit. Thank you so much.